wish I could play against him every single night. Just that competitive juice, just that feel, just going against one of the greatest. You can never take that for granted. So I'm not glad. It's really surreal, actually. You're not going to get a sense for it until you play him next year and he's not in the lineup.
Listen, Kobe, like I said, this entire time, he's our Michael Jordan for my generation. He's one of the best to ever lace him up, and it's been a pleasure and an honor to compete against him again, basically almost my entire career. I wish him nothing but the best for life after basketball. The league is going to miss, obviously, one of the greatest to ever play. His competitiveness, his clutch shots. That's what I remember the most, and I always tell the story that after games, sometimes we were in Central Time. I was rushing home to watch Kobe do his thing in the fourth quarters, and when they're in LA, and him taking over games. I've been a part one time when he outscored our entire team through three quarters here and making a three with the left hand. In our generation, he was the greatest shot maker we had. So he's incredible to watch.
He's definitely one of the greats, one of the best to ever do it. Not just in Lakerland, but in NBA. Period. The way that he approached the game, the way that he committed himself to this game of basketball for all these years. He definitely go down as one of the greats.
I think just the competitiveness. You seen right there at the end, the game was pretty much already in hand and Kobe was still picking up, Pablo. Everybody don't do that, So only certain people probably will understand the grind and the meaning of that 20 seasons in. He could have just let him dribble the clock out, but that's just how much he loves to compete.
Just his greatness, man. It's hard to be great for that moment. It's easy to have a couple games here and there, and get a nice contract, but it's hard to be great for so long. And, he's been great for maybe 19 out of 20 years. Maybe that rookie year wasn't great, but he's been great for a long time, man. And to do it at that level for so many years with guys coming after you, I just have a tremendous amount of respect for that. And obviously, what he did in between the lines as a competitor is, it's not many guys who've done that to play this game of basketball. And most of anything, he hasn't had an easy run to do it. He got a lot of injuries along the way. And I know how hard it is to come back from injuries. And he's came back stronger and stronger and stronger every time, injuries came. And that's harder than anything, when you have to go through some of the injuries that, you have to bounce back from.
He's always one of the, you go through this business for a long time, there are always some players that you wish you'd have gotten to know better and that you had opportunity to coach and see what they're really made of and see what makes them tick, and he's one of those guys.
He's a competitor. He showed it tonight. Dislocated his finger in that last quarter, and he's still out there. He still wants to play. And that's him in a nutshell.
Is it weird to see Kobe smiling that much on the court?
Yeah, it is. But the thing is, though, he'll smile, but he's still going to bring it. That's the thing, we always look at guys' facial expressions and we want them to be like straight-faced and, always serious. But when a ball's in play, man, you're going to play the game. Man. That's how I am. And tonight was no different. I challenged him, he challenged me. Nobody backed down. And that's what great, that's great basketball right there. That's all you want. I was looking forward to it. When he didn't play last time, I was a little upset because I wanted to go out there and guard him and be physical with him and just play the game with him. And I knew it was going to make me a better player for my team tonight. And, I was able to, from the beginning, man, just be physical and play the game and, just enjoy both ends of the floor. Tonight was great. And that's how every, great player, when we play them, that's how it feels. Like I said, great players elevate your game, elevate the team, and he's one of those guys.
Do you guys exchange shoes?
Yeah. Yeah, don't tell nobody though, man. I want to be looked at as a softie.
As athletic as he is, or was, just how fundamentally sound he is as a basketball player, that appreciation of the game I think goes unnoticed sometimes, but the finite details of the game, such as footwork or anything like that, the mid-range game that I've been watching, that I've tried to implement in my game, that's something that I love. A lot of people like seeing highlight dunks, a lot of crossovers and stuff like that, but for me, when I'm watching Kobe, I really just watch how detailed he is and just watching how he reads the game. So that fundamentally sound, I have a true appreciation of that, and I ask him all the time about it, just and also the mental approach as well, but that goes beyond words.
Yeah, it was awesome. Obviously, we've been playing against him lately. You know, we did a big tribute in San Antonio and All-Star break, and now this one was the last one. So, you know, it was just an honor, and it was just amazing to play against him all those years. He was the Jordan of our generation.
Well, we went through a lot, you know, and we had incredible times, the best of my career as an NBA player, and we had some rougher times after because of all the changes and decisions that were made. So, but, you know, we always stuck together, and our relationship just grew stronger. So you know, I'm just extremely happy that I was able to share those moments with him and go through all those seasons.